opposite. I got a question, Mayor. The issue of one of the scholarship program in D.C., which, let me tell you, this is near and dear, especially in a city like this. Should the program allow new students into the program in the, at the present and the future as we have in the past?
Yeah, our administration supports both the three-sector approach, and then we have a statement which has been crafted, which would allow the continued operations of the program and the same numbers of people in the program, which there are some people who would want less, some people who would want more. You could classify that as more kids into the program because they're new kids, or you could just classify it as the same number of slots. We have supported the same number of slots.
So in other words, you support maintaining this into the foreseeable future, where if you don't allow new kids in, you're basically designing the demise of the option for the inner city.
No, that would be one of the extremes. We are our administration has adopted a position that's a little bit more in the middle, which would to support the same number of slots, which would allow new kids in to a certain degree, but not any growth in the program. And just the quick explanation is the chancellor believes that within a short period of time, but probably more in the 5 to 6 year range, we will have our school system at a level that it will be a much more solid option for all the kids in the city.
And Mayor, this is very delicate for me. I owned a place in D.C., and sadly, my wife was emphatic that we leave the district because of the lack of opportunities here. The other issue that's going to be interesting in this city is that now that I don't own a place here, but I've got a friend like Bob Filner, where the district now has created a tax penalty for people that are required by federal law not to be residents of D.C., but live here and work here. And the district is taxing them basically because they are not residents, and i.e. members of Congress. We legally cannot be a resident, a voting resident in D.C., but Bob's tax is more than his partner because he's a congressman and not allowed to do that under federal law. Has anybody even discussed that catch-22? I know it's small, but this is the kind of situation that exists in a federal city, the nation's capital, that doesn't exist in other cities.
If I've been briefed on that, I don't recall. Yield to Dr. Ghani. Let me just say, in reference to the schools, as I yield, as we both support the type of school reform that Chancellor Rhee has been pushing over the past 2 years, I do believe that the bill before us will allow her to move even faster by having a greater understanding of what her ability to spend dollars are. Dr. Ghani, I don't know if you have any information about the bill.
I think Mayor spoke quite well on that.
Okay. Just like to give them a choice rather than having to pack up and leave like a lot of people have done, sadly. And a lot of people who don't have the financial ability to pack up and leave like I did and give my children those options, those that are in D.C. that don't have that financial ability should be able to have the same opportunities that my children had.